Pyramids in Egypt just don't make sense. That's about the only fact we know about them. They are so perplexing to modern day scientists and theorists that no theory has yet been able to explain just exactly how and why they were made. They are said to have been built more than 4,500 years ago. However, this and many other questions surrounding the pyramids have been up for debate for hundreds of years, with seemingly nobody coming to an agreement. All theories have still yet to be proven, but there is endless amount of conspiracy that surprisingly make a lot of sense, if you have an open mind. The two main theories that come up are, did humans build the pyramids, or did aliens? Let's take a look. So let's just say the aliens did it. You'd be surprised just how many people truly believe that extraterrestrial beings had a part to play in the design and execution of the pyramids. The Great Pyramid is made of millions of precisely crafted stones, with each stone weighing at least 2 tons each. Despite how far we have come in technological advances, building a replica of the pyramids would be an indescribable challenge. Even using the world's best construction resources, it would be extremely difficult to replicate the perfect nature that the creators of the pyramids were able to achieve so quickly. Not convinced yet? Well, the pyramids are even constructed in relation to an astronomical configuration. Many theorists have pointed out that the pyramids align with the stars in Orion's belt. Not only are the pyramids aligned with the stars, but they even face true north. The placement of the North Pole has shifted over time, yet the pyramids have still managed to stay exactly aligned. The architects of these pyramids built them with such precision that we struggle to fathom that earthly hands could complete such a perfect thing. Now, let's see how humans did it. A common theory is the idea that humans built the pyramids as some form of complex power source. It was initially believed that all pyramids that were built were used as tombs for Egyptian pharaohs. But the Great Pyramid of Giza does not contain any of the typical qualities that your traditional tomb would have, such as elaborate large-scale artifacts, sealed entrances, and the main giveaway, mummified bodies. A study has revealed that the Great Pyramid of Giza can focus electromagnetic energy. So, what does this mean? While the physical properties of the pyramid are still up for debate, the passageways throughout the underground tunnels are lined with granite, a conductor of piezoelectricity, meaning electricity that is made through pushing, movement, or squeezing. The studies show that the pyramid can concentrate electromagnetic energy underneath the base of the construction, as well as the internal chambers within. Granite was not available in abundance back then, so it does beg the question, why use it if a power plant wasn't its purpose? But how did they do it exactly? It is believed that it took 40,000 people to construct the pyramids. Each block would have been individually pulled by a large group of people, presumably by sledges. If us humans did actually design and build such an incredible piece of history, it is unfortunate to say that many people died during its creation. The Pyramid of Giza is 481 feet tall. To put this into perspective, imagine thousands and thousands of people building the Eiffel Tower with bare feet, no headgear, and some are falling off the sides because they aren't attached to anything. Pretty insane. If aliens really did make the pyramids, we should probably find a way to say thank you. And if us humans did it, then we should also probably give them a pat on the back too. Or maybe we even teamed up and did it together. Who knows? A little extraterrestrial action never hurt anybody.